think what actually happens is this one's in the protocol actually. What are the findings from the scientists that conducted the informant interviews? So this is a summary of essentially what we're presenting from the coffee panel as well. So the sources of agriculture credits in these rural spaces are widely spread. They're quite strategically located and accessible to these coffee farmers. Now, the farmers are using a mixture of both informal and informal. There is a mixture of these credit providers in these survey districts. And farmers are accessing these institutions. What we found rather interesting is that the demand for agricultural credits far outweighs what the credit facilities are able to avail to the farmers. So quite consistently, people mentioned that although they applied for certain amounts from the SACOs only gave them a certain percentage of what they applied for. And the SACOs also mentioned that they applied for a certain amount from larger lending institutions and couldn't obtain the credits that they asked for, and that meant that they had to cut what they were to give out. There are also issues of timeliness of provision of this credit coming out here. But the demand we found quite interestingly. Quite high up there. There was an issue on willingness to pay back and ability to pay back. And again, it might be related to the lending rates. So again, there were variations in each of the districts. Some places we just had very low default rates, and in other places, the defaulters were quite many. So typically, SACOs borrow at a much lower percentage, around 11, they mentioned, and lend at 3% per month. And even at 3% per month, so 36% per annum, farmers are still borrowing and are able to pay back, and essentially for coffee production. And I thought this is related. We found that the mechanisms and processes for accessing this credit are very long, bureaucratic, and in some instances a deterrent to new applicants. So there are long application, appraisal, approval, and disbursement processes that, again, limited people going to particular institutions. And the risks involved in credit recovery, again, varied, I've explained that one, and water, again, coming out as a key constraint in coffee production. What are the implications of our findings? And how do we address these in our model that is going to implement it? So our analysis suggests that farmers are accessing agriculture credit for coffee production and that this demand is real. But if new players are to be attracted into the sector, the lending rates have got to be considered. And this is where we need guarantees on the lending rates. So it has to be very, very low. Farmers are able to and have the land to expand and set up new coffee plantings. They have up to around 2 acres. So pushing for increase in land size is something that is possible. But in our model, we are saying let us maximize the 1 acre space. And it's something that my colleague the unfriendly credit access mechanisms, and these hinder uptake of credit for coffee production. Now, these bureaucracies in our model, we suggest ways of limiting them and improving recovery through some transparent mechanisms. Water, which is a key problem related to weather changes. Again, in our model, among the inputs, so the various inputs that we suggest, but among them is low-cost irrigation technologies. And then the novelty here, again, we bring on board is insurance companies coming on board to take care of the risks in production. It is included in our model as well. I thank you.